When you don't say good things about yourself, you reap what you say. So when you say I'm ugly, you reap ugliness. When you say I am poor, you reap poverty. Glory to God. I am not the one that said it. It's He said, you reap what you sow. Anything you say is what you sow. So if I will reap what I sow, then I have so good things. I have to sow rich cheese around me that I may reap riches. Glory to God. The reaping is so important. You know, they don't move around sowing in tears shall reap joy. Glory to God. Sowing is with tears, but reaping is with joy. So if you sow bad things concerning yourself, you are reaping bad things. You can change, listen to me, you can change the events around you by what you say.
Amen.
Change things.
Yeah.
Change things. It's not how long, listen, it's not how long you have been with you that matters.
That's
it's
right.
How connected you are with the grace and
character. Yeah.
Some of you think that, listen, we are equal in fellowship,
yeah,
but we are not equal in responsibility.
No.
We are not equal in
responsibility.
We are equal in fellowship. What makes me is the right thing.
Amen.
In all your getting, get understanding. You need to start thinking differently. Because if you don't think, you can't get anything.
That's right.
Before you can succeed in life, you need to have meeting with yourself.
Amen.
Not with anybody.
No,
sit down with yourself and ask yourself questions. Some of you, you're saying, I need to just grow up and be like a big girl. I need to grow up. It's good. We grow. Until you hit 18, you say, I'm a big girl. You hit out of house. Life is sweet at 25. And that's when you start getting the reality of life. Then when you hit 30, and as soon as you hit 30, you know, as soon as you hit 20, 3, 24, it will start running, 26, 27, 28. When you reach that 31, 32, 30, before you know it, 40. Before you know it, you start having a wrinkle. Before you know it, instead of you to talk to your mirror, you now allow your mirror to be talking to you. You look at yourself in the mirror, say, look up. You think that your mirror is just for makeup?
No.
You think that your mirror is for you to look at yourself and tell yourself, I am rich.
Yeah.
I will succeed.
Yeah.
Hear me, what you say determines what you get.
Yeah.
Faith is having, you know, confidence, practical confidence in God's word until you speak out faith, you can't receive anything. You see, prophet is crystal over here, I'm prophesying and shout, and you think he's just shouting.
No.
You feel, instead of you to tap into what they carry, when you come to church like and you're looking around,
yeah,
I take me selfie.
Yeah.
Because you lose focus.
Yeah.
We not to take pictures in church is good,
yeah,
but can't you wait after service?
Yeah.
Some people just sit at the back there. Listen, they don't focus. The key to America is focus.
Amen.
Elijah said to Nash, if you can see me, go. Focus. 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 If you don't see me, go, you can't receive anything like that. There is something they call grace that opens everybody's heart. Amen. If you are too familiar with your prophetess yet, you can't get anything from her. You will just come,
go like that.
As it was in the beginning, so shall it be, life without end.
And that's not good. You need to focus.
I want you to know that your faith, when you put it in action, you start seeing the works of God. Lift up your right hand and say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Give me what I'm looking for.
Give me what I'm looking for.
If you will shout amen three times.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Faith, when you release it, you get the profit.
Oh, yeah.
But some of us, we don't make use of our mouth. Oh. We can only use our mouth against ourselves.
Yeah.
It's like you're having a gun, you shoot yourself at the foot.
Yeah.
Instead of shooting the target, you shoot yourself.
Yeah.
I am poor. You're shooting yourself. Listen to me, you don't have problem. What you have, you don't have problem. What is there is what they call challenges.
Yes.
It's part of life. Stop saying, I have this, I have this. No, my family is poor, my mother is poor, my father is poor. Me too, I am. Are you okay? It's a challenge. Lift up your hand and say, Father,
Father,
I'm coming out of this challenge.
I am coming out of this challenge.
Quickly, let me show you something in the book of John, chapter 2, verse 17 and 18.
Amen.
Even so, if it has no work, even so, faith, if it has no work, is dead. If you have no work, it's dead and arrive out.
Yes.
Any faith that have no work is what?
Dead.
In arrive out. It's dead. You need to work it out. When I tell you, you are going to succeed. Amen. Start praying and believing.
Amen.
Yeah. As I walk.
Yes.
Somebody called me yesterday. Say, man of God, I want you to date me. Today. Today. So his problem is ordination.
Yeah.
So ordination, without ordination, you can't preach.
You want a title.
You want a title.
Yeah.
Can I shock him?
Well,
have you go to any Bible school?
No.
I never sit down in the Bible school.
What?
In my life. Am I not preaching?
Yes.
Am I not being
Very well.
I have no certificate of anything, no secondary school, primary school, anything. I don't have. But I'm successful.
Amen. Very much success.
Come on.
I'm not doing something here.
Yes.
You don't wait until your day, you die is when that demons. Demons don't run away from certificate. Demons don't run away with title.
No.
I just I said, when last have you heard me talk about ordination? If God didn't call. So don't wait for ordination. But if I'm also there, you go and look for 10,000 TT dollars.
Then I'm across.
Give me 10,000 TT dollars.
That's the average.
Any person that has 10,000 TT dollars, I will. Because you need paper. I will give you paper and take paper. There will be track by butter, paper for paper. And paper for paper. Faith without work is dead.
Yeah.
Faith in your heart must be released through your mouth. Don't tell me I have faith in my heart. Release it. AK-47 loaded without shooting. It's a dog. What makes AK-47 is when you get pa pa pa. Am I doing someone here?
Yes.
What makes you is what you say.
Yes.
Not what you wear.
Never.
The difference between your prime minister and the prime minister of other countries is the way they take
time. Yeah.
Some president will stay like this and blow their eyes on the people. And the Lord is in this country will succeed if you really understand that we are all one and one citizen together. And together we will stand.
Yes.
But some president will not look at the king.
Yeah, we understand.
They just come out and talk.
You understand their stuff.
Amen.
Yeah.
Have you seen any American president that come to me that is looking?
Nah,
even when you try to copy them and they put the screen there for you, you will even see some people that they are reading in the screen.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
No trade.
Amen.
Amen.
Have you seen any American president, past and present, even our brother Donald Trump, that come to United Nations or Commonwealth and start reading on paper?
No.
That's what makes them there. When they stand, everything is in their head. If you cannot put it in your head, America cannot keep you behind
themselves.
Right.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Even if you say this person is the worst American president, he's still the best president in the whole world.
That's right.
Because he can still be the best in every other country. Right. It's only in America they feel this one is dumb.
Yeah.
But that dumb in America is a professional abroad.
Yes.
Somebody's not getting it.
Yeah.
May God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said, may God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said, may God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You need to produce this miracle in your mouth. The power of faith is activated and is into action when you speak it.
Amen.
Make use of your mouth.
Yeah.
This week, that's just what I'm here.
This week.
To tell you, make use of your mouth. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. And always they close this.
Right.
Make use of your mouth.
Yeah.
What do you say about yourself?
Amen.
What do you say about your business?
Yes.
What do you say about your home? Don't go around looking for people to appreciate you.
No.
If you cannot appreciate yourself.
Right.
If you are like Crystal, if Crystal is singing, he doesn't know whether you are backing her or not. She's singing.
Yeah, that's right.
Am I right?
Yeah,
she's just singing and jumping and whether you like joint. If you don't joint, she's praising her God. So all you do is to join the train.
Yes, yes.
It doesn't matter how you are sitting on a rocket chair, you're going nowhere.
No.
All you do, front, back, as it was in the beginning. So shall it be. More without end. One place. You need to move forward. Word of God that is located in your mouth, believing it and speaking it out, men will wonder about you. Look down on men that carry grace.
Never.
Some of you come to someone that carry grace. You want to shake it. Hey, you want to rock it. It's not by shaking and mocking.
That's right.
A man that has grace, the anointing is not in his
hand. No,
every religion, the people that have anointing is on their feet.
Right.
You shake it, man of God, praise God, and you embrace it. The only thing you give is your powder face on your shirt. And if you embrace me and your power spoil my right, I remove it and give you to go and wash it. Are you thinking to somebody in the service? You just come and embrace me and say, yeah, I'll come. You spoil my, take this suit. Go and wash it, bring it back. Amen.
Amen.
God, so that you know how much they charge me in cleaning it, in dry cleaning it. So next time if I wear white, don't come close. Because if you come close, you're going to wash it. I talk too much now. Lift up your hand and say, my father, my maker.
My father, my maker.
I'll make use of my tongue.
I'll make use of my tongue.
When you talk to a church, some people, that man doesn't even preach Rhema. He doesn't preach what he's saying at all. He has grace.
Yes, yes.
One day I come to a man of God's meeting in my church before he passed the cross. I was in his meeting. Some boys that come with me, some pastors that come with me, they say, no, this man, he doesn't understand the place. They will come back when they went to their hotel. In the hotel, I don't know. that I was sitting down there to listen to this man. This elderly man was coming down from the altar, was talking, and come where I am and stand to talk to me. I didn't even know what he's saying, but I kneeled down and held his shoe. What he's saying, I didn't hear today. But what he carried is what I need.
Yeah.
After that, the man spent more than 1 year, he died. And I now know what he said to me just on TV, on video, on Facebook. And what did he say? God will use you. And I see great things just as, but I contact it.
Yes.
There are some of us, we come to listen to someone that's speaking African English without contacting the grace of God. You need to learn how to contact grace.
Amen.
You see a woman that has 6 children that listen to him, to her. 6 children. And all listening to her. If she say come, they come. Go, they go. And they are 30, 28. You still controlling them. And you have one that never listened to you. You don't need prayer. You don't need to go. Go to that woman and give her money and say, please, this thing that make you to control your children.
I need it.
I need to control my wife. You can't control her. And somebody's controlling 6. And sometimes you see somebody that married for 30 years and they're not talking about divorcing. They are not talking about separating.
No.
They are like 5 and 6.
Yeah.
Instead of you to go close to them and contact what keeps them together. And you are still managing a boyfriend that is in your life for 8 years without saying, I want to. You never say, I want to. Man.
No.
Not talk about me. You never say it. He's just here. You never say, I want to man. Forget about the ring. Just man. All you need to do is to go to these ones that have been together, man. Something, something grace they can. As soon as you owe it, grace they can. The grace they can will transfer. Listen to me. They don't transfer grace by making of man. They transfer grace by sowing of seed and respecting grace. Grace. Always follow people that respect it.
Amen.
You can get grace that somebody carry.
If you don't respect,
grace, you carry. You come to Africa, we are preaching. People are running to touch our shoe. You say, where is Africa? They are worshiping the man. They are not worshiping the man.
Yes.
It's the grace. They know what grace is.
Yes.
And we come here. Nobody talk if they want this fog. We continue walking you. But don't use your powder to spread my clothes. But for walking, we continue. If you need handshake, we shake. But it surprises you that when you come to Africa, the same person you are just talking with, so people are kneeling down for him to just pass by where they are. Just to pass. And you think, this is people, and no wonder they prosper. No wonder they honor a man with grace and not send you ordinary letter they send you. You start sending your money to them. They say, those Africans use Obia on you. Not Obia, not all of them to Obia. Many of them are in churches.
Yeah.
Say, Father, bless you. The white people come and take from our Father. We want to take back from them.
Yeah.
I will build a church for you. There is nothing sweet called that building a church for you. You know the centurion? Centurion, is he a Christian? He built a synagogue.
Yeah.
And they come to Jesus.
Yeah.
He said, this man built a synagogue for us. Testimony of what you do can open door for you.
Yeah.
And Jesus stand up and said, let's go to you.
Yeah.
The centurion said, no, no, no. I'm a man under authority.
Yeah. Just me.
And many of us, we don't believe in saying a word. Pastor, you must come. You must come. Pastor, come. Pastor, there are some people, they don't come to church again because prophet is saying he's coming to my house.
And in
my car, I'm not going to. What concerns me? Am I the person that have problems? I pay him money to come to your house. Have any person pay me money to come to his house? If I say I'm coming to your house, I am not God. I can only go. I want to come, but there is something that is following me. If he's not going with me, I go nowhere. Because if somebody like me come to this country without being a preacher, many of you will not talk to me.
No.
Many of you, even if I greet you in a shopping mall, you look at me.
Sure.
If I didn't come here as a preacher, I may be in Shabana High Street selling pack on the road.
No, they say I'm dirty.
Or I may be working in security in one place or the other.
Yes, maybe I was in there.
You will not even speak to me. There is something that brings me here and I don't jeopardize with it. Because there is a force that comes with me. And that force that comes with me, I don't play with it. Instead of me to play with it, it's better I die. I can't. Because without him, I am not a graduate. Without him, I have no certificate. Without him, I'm supposed to be the most stupid person on earth. Either I become an armed or drug dealer or whatever, or breaking pipeline in my country, carrying gun and face the government and die useless death. But this man lift me from somewhere and take me to 60 something countries on earth.
Amen.
With this Bible.
Amen.
And you tell me to play with it. You can't play with it, man. I can't. Even in the dream, I can't play with it. I know what grace is. And when I see a man that has grace, I contact him. Can I tell you how grace has opened up? Somebody invited me to come and preach in his church. He has a very big church. And as I come to this church, he has a young wife. Because he has a young wife. But I love the grace this man can. So he called. When I come to his church, he's not yet out. I come on time. And the young wife is just there. And this wife is even, I see her too much. And before she married that man, she was one of the ushers in my own church. Before she married that man. So will I now go there and belittle her?
No.
Because he married that man, she had the same respect with that man. Do you know that nobody was happy? Because she, can you imagine? You are going kneeling down. And now you are married to somebody I respect so much. And I come to the church, there were like 3,000 people in that church.
Wow.
And as soon as I walk into the church, everybody was happy. Hey, commander, I say, you know. And when I go straight and kneel down before this girl, you know, mama, thank God that I'm here. Oh God, glory to God, mama, God bless. People look at me as fool. I'm not a fool. If I'm not contacting from the man, I'm contacting from the woman. Because two of them are one. And people were looking at me like,
this commander at all.
Yeah.
But do you know that after the meeting, when the man come to greet the man, do you know that after the meeting, one woman enter the office? I said, what is that? I didn't know. In Lagos State, Nigeria. And the woman come and say, I respect your community.
Amen.
This woman said that she's from Osha.
Yeah.
And everybody in the church was so surprised the way you greeted her. And we lost contact like 6 years. The way you greeted her is a man. I have to do something for this. I love what. Do you know that the house I have in Lagos is now what I buy? Just for seeing me greeting somebody without minding that person. There are some of you.
Why?
If somebody is living with you and let the person is higher than you, don't criticize the person.
No.
Go and respect the person.
Yeah.
The person will take you to the standard there. Am I doing something?
Yeah.
People may look down on you, but don't look down on yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Humility is not stupidity.
No.
Am I doing something?
Yes.
When you
will not put you, say, God, lift you up.
Amen.
And he will present you with 490 people.
Amen.
Imagine somebody.
Yes.
The creative force of your mouth can do anything.
Amen.
People were surprised.
Yeah.
And even the husband was even surprised.
Yeah.
Everybody was surprised.
Yeah.
Wow. I need to respect her. Yeah. I don't wait for her to say, some people will just come and say, hey, it's not over with me now. I know pastors like that.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, had it been woman first seen to enter, she could have been the person that first and wrong.
Yeah.
But she didn't see me.
Okay.
So she's talking to somebody when I have already getting to where she is. When I was even appreciating her, she was high. And that appreciation gave me heart.
Yeah.
Look down on anything around you.
Right.
The problem you have is that, hey, is that not Krista? He just joined church 2 years ago. And why was I especially? You're wasting your time. Any person that have grace, have grace.
Yeah.
There's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah.
Just like you see St. Luan coming to pray, and he said, I'm just wasting your bloody time.
Yeah, yeah.
People with grace is with grace.
Amen.
You need to honor the grace they carry.
Amen.
So they may be your friend before, yeah, but when they have grace, respect grace.
Yeah.
They don't even entangle in families.
Yeah.
Some people will marry a man before you know they talk to the person anyhow.
Yeah.
Can you marry an Ojama and talk to him anyhow? Try it. All he needs is just to go to one of his shrines. You see yourself somewhere. You need to learn how to respect and value people. Can I hear someone say, I hear. Your tongue is a target or is a trigger of signs. Your tongue is what? A trigger of signs. You must accept the responsibility of anything that happens around you. If you are poor, don't blame your uncle. You cost it. Because if your uncle says you'll be poor, why not say I am rich? Feel this thing. You are responsible of everything that happened around you. Lift your hand and say, Father, bless me now.
Bless me now.
Mark chapter 16, verse 17. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out devil. They shall speak with a new tongue. Do you know what that means? Newton. Can I tell you something? This afternoon, you must have what they call brain transplant. Mind transplant. So you can speak Newton. Can I hear someone say speak? Say it like a stammer. Speak. Am I going someone here? It says they will speak in Newton. Speak new tongues. Do you know the new tongues? Don't be like Trinidad. You know before. The way they normally take things. You don't take them anymore. You are speaking new things. You are talking new things into existence. When somebody, can you imagine somebody in Trinidad come to you and talk? The way you respond, you say, I was thinking you're Trini. Because he wants you to be like Trini.
Yeah.
But you have got it. Another tongue.
Yeah.
That is to say, you have gotten another way of addressing issues.
Yeah.
Can I talk?
Yeah.
It's just like from next month now, we'll be having some things. We'll be, because I want you to change.
Amen.
Change your mentality. Change the way you think. Change the way things happen around you. Change it. Any person that gives you accommodation, respect the person. Because the person has helped your life.
Yes.
I was talking to Professor Christa. I said, you are paying 2,500 euros. He said, yes. 2500 he says, that's what he pays says, every month he says. I say, do you know that every day, don't call it a month, call it daily.
Yeah.
Put that 2500 daily is $85 a day.
Yeah.
So any day you don't have $85, your name is sorry. You are falling short. So you must make sure that people around you, people that will add to you. And that will help you. If you see somebody, you appreciate the person so that that person can help your life. Everybody is here to help each other. There are some of us here, they have a car, as soon as church finish, they go. They will not even look for people that go
now.
One day your car will be old. They don't have a car today, they can't have a car. The only thing is that the type of car God wants them to use is not yet manufactured. You'll be surprised that when they buy their own is the one flying and your own is still riding on the road. It's just like people that buy this one, and now they're winding up the glass with their hand, and another person is just coming to the door. Even they can even stay here and wind down the glass, start their car. Some cars now have remote that will revise it and drive it out for you. As I'm going, if I'm going out, I just press the car will just come out. I'm back where you want to just enter. And go. And you are still saying, I have a car. What do you have? Some of you said the car, what you are calling car is even laughing at you. When you put the keys in. You don't know that car laugh. And some, the one you are calling, even if you start, he said, oh, can somebody with you? Can somebody? Even some of them, as you see them sometimes, they don't normally drive it in the daytime, they drive it in cooling day. They know that police is going away. Because the smoke that is coming out already, the smoke, how smoke can carry coronavirus in? May God help us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
The sound from your mouth determines the sign you see in your life.
Yeah.
I want you to be faithful to God and He will be graceful to you.
Yeah.
Am I doing somebody here?
Yeah.
Am I doing somebody here?
Yeah.
God wants to see you act. Act faith. Act it. Act it. Act it. I am rich. That is acting. You're acting. I'm a successful man. You are not boosting. You are acting. Amen. Somebody say, I see husband. He say, hey, I'm not a big man. Are you okay? I see your husband. He's on his way. He's coming. Maybe any moment your mind will be. You check it out, the problem for me. You are acting it. Acting it. Can I for the act? Do you know that some people will see you and they think you have a car? They may think you have a car and they will come close to you and say, oh, mommy, please can you? After service, I want to join you. You say, hey, me, car. I don't have, I'm waiting for that. You know why he doesn't ask you for that? He has seen it in the spirit.
Right.
The problem you have is that you have not seen what that person sees.
Right.
What you need to do, well, I'm not going yet, but you can join other people. Let's come on. You are not faking, you are acting. I'm not doing somebody here. God wants to see you act by faith. Do not just speak the word, also act the word. Act it. Can I just say act it?
Act it.
God is interested to weigh your action. He wants to win your action before he can give you what you're looking for.
Amen.
Some of you are only waiting until Mama, am I going to preach? Pastor, Bishop, making confusion. If you don't preach, can't you preach in Shawana High School?
Yeah.
Can't you go to Shawana and preach?
Yeah.
But can't you go back to Africa and say, return! People will listen to you.
Yeah.
Well, the kingdom of God is at you. You only want to come and preach in church.
Yeah.
And submit. Don't tell them to preach on Sunday. They start being angry.
Yeah.
They want to preach on Sunday. Every time you tell me to meet, when am I preaching on Sunday? If you want to preach on Sunday, go to Shabbat and ask
them. Sunday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
You can preach all the days. I want to be somebody here.
Yeah.
Don't you know where to buy megaphone or whatever?
Yeah.
This one, police come and they say, hey, sir, don't you know where they are? Do you think it's only police they have?
No.
It's a demand here. Megaphone.
Yeah.
Take it and buy it.
Go back.
Just come and talk. People will listen.
Amen.
And every time you hear me, do you know, one day, I just see somebody. This pastor have a mama chin. You know mama?
Yeah.
He's behaving as if he's heaven. Even when I come to preach for him, he never uses it to come and carry me there. That is 2003. And when the man invited me, I was like 2002. When the man happy, when he invited me, I was happy. At least let me go and join him. He's not never bringing it. He never used it. He put me in another class, then in his cradle. You're wasted. This God that has taken me this far cannot abandon me. I was thinking that that's just for that day. For 3 days, I preached for this man.
Never.
If you use the car to come to hotel, see me, and when I'm about going to preach, at least as a guest speaker, he should drive with you. For where? 3 days. And the man never came out. And that one. Despite how I preach, I'm prophesying. No. Touch me one more time. No. Touch me one more time. Oh, no. I need a touch from the Master. I need a touch from the Lord. Touch me one more time.
Hallelujah.
3 days the man never ever. I never
believed.
Please, take your picture, please. Even if it's Facebook, you post it. I'm not. I finish and I left. And I look at the room. I feel about be moving and stop and look.
Yeah.
They really made me to look back. And I sit down and have a conference with myself. And I say to myself, if I have that kind of car,
I'll preach.
I'll be preaching it.
Yeah.
I'll use it to carry people to church.
Yes.
That's just what I do.
Yes.
This was 6 months later.
Hey.
Was my birthday.
Yeah.
And they just give it to
me.
I never tell anybody about it. But because I have the desire in my heart, all I do, I want to buy all my toy. Yeah, toy car. And keep it on my altar. Because I learned that thing from a man called Jacob. You know Jacob?
Yeah.
When they have an agreement, every spotted sheep is his own.
Yeah.
God give him an idea to carve spotted wool and put it in the water. Any sheep that is pregnant, take it to the water to drink.
Yeah.
And they are drinking and looking at that, it reflects to what they carry.
Yeah.
I put it in my altar as it needs to reflect. And 6 months later, I have it. Do you know the first thing I do? I write a lot of things on the body. When I drive to a place and I put like in Trinidad, then they call them mic man.
Yeah.
You know that kind of,
yeah.
I put the small ones on top of it. When I come to a market, I park and I come out and climb it and stand on top. You got my order. Everybody, my name is Thomas Garcia. People, if you don't want to listen, you come to see him. Then you now see that what people are using as if they're in heaven. When God give it to you as a Christian, rubbish it for people. I stand on it until I give it out to my one of my fathers in the Lord, and another person bless me with another one. I never ask for them. God give you your heart desire.
Amen.
What do you desire? Some of you are desiring another person's man. That's why you can't have it. Your eyes is closed towards your own man because he is short and he has no money.
Come on.
And you never know, just associating with that person. Money comes.
Yeah.
But you know, they have what they call malaria.
Yeah.
And malaria.
Yeah.
Malaria.
Malaria.
Malaria is what mosquito give.
Yeah.
Malaria is people that always believe it's a man that must bless someone.
Oh,
they believe it's only a man that can buy you a house. I talk too much. If only you can open your eyes, you will see what belongs to you. Some of you are not looking at it because it doesn't look like it. Gold don't look like gold until it passes through. If I bring gold now and drop it here, you will not even touch it. You think it's not?
Yeah.
And they never know it's good until it passes through fire, pass through process, and the real thing comes. That's when you are going after it. There are some women in your life that don't look like what you want, but there are men in your life that don't look like what you want, but. There are some contacts around you. It doesn't look like the contact you need. But Mala Supra. Doesn't look like it. But that is it. That is what you need. I pray that the Lord open your spiritual
heart.
If you shout amen, you'll get it again.
Amen.
One of my pastor was wedding. I told him, don't wait when you want to wear. And because of the one, normally he doesn't want to wear in the church. He said he wants to wear in his village. I said, well, I don't have it at that time. Actually, I don't have, because sometimes there's something I call the rich also cry.
Yeah.
And sometimes the rich person may not have it. You see, like when you like and go jump, there is a time. You may not even know, maybe this one that they don't have to be done. That the past always covered them.
Yeah.
So I tell the guy, But how much to hire vehicles for you? You mentioned, I don't give my brother, I'll keep you one of my car. Go and take any one I use. You went and carry this car, but I never use it up to 9 months. Very powerful car. I told him, let me give you a drive. He doesn't like my drive. Pastors that don't like people, I don't know who you are. Your hell fire. When you go there, if your hair fire is 10 degrees, Satan will increase it to 90.
Yeah.
To hit you. Pastors that don't like it. Now, my driver said to me, man of God, it's good that, because my driver knows that I don't have money. He said, it's good that you don't have money. But if I'm to advise you, tell them to go and wait anyhow they want to wait. When you come back from abroad, you can pay some of your bills.
Yeah.
And giving them this car without him coming to drive it. Because that this guy, he know him, that I don't know this pastor. That is why the pastor don't like him.
Yeah.
The pastor wants to live above his income. Yeah. That I should not give him the car. Unless he will go to drive them to the wedding, they finish, he come back with the car. And I didn't listen to him then. I left to go with the car. Went home, gave the car to his brother. Maybe he told him he bought it.
Yeah.
And the brother knew him much of the car. Today, even the brother mashed up the car, he might tell me that the car is mashed. Until the same driver called me and said, man of God, I don't want to give you information in long run, but I know that car you give. Call them to bring you because they never bring back that car after wedding. And since this car has not come back 2 days, I believe that this car is gone.
Hey.
I said, why do you talk like that? I said, I know them. Can I hear someone say, I know them?
I know them.
You know that even when the man comes back and they see this car, the car is gone, I can't use it, nothing. It's just ripped off. And I said, why didn't you drive the car yourself? You say you will drive it. That you have the driver. Why your brother? But anyway, I thank God that your brother did not die. They could have said, I use your brother for money ritual.
Yeah.
Because in Africa, things like that, they say it's money ritual. And that is the thing I use to get power. Because they believe in killing to get power.
Wow.
After I talked to him, I said, that is bad. Do you know that after because I have to shout, because it's my money.
Yeah.
Can I buy a car for $700,000 and you mash it up and I will not just shout? And we don't have insurance in our country. Car gone, car gone. You need to buy it cash. They don't sell it on credit. And you mash it. That, you say that money is gone.
Wow.
And the man said, I'm shouting at him. He left the church. I shout at you because I'm kind of left the church. When he left, he didn't tell me. He didn't carry some things that is in their past. And they tell me, I just laugh. They say, why are you laughing? I say, I'm laughing because I see trouble following a man that doesn't deserve it. I never say anything. But do you know today? The pastor can not pastor anywhere. God really blessed them. They have like 4 children now. Having children is not a problem. They didn't go to school. The children cannot go to school. And they are living. Bond house is better than where he's living. And the man now is doing bricklayer in Nigeria. Bricklayer people here are. The people that do bricklayer here, they are even rich than the one that do it in Nigeria. Because the people here can get good money.
Oh,
yeah. But in Africa, do you know a day you walk with them, a day like in Nigeria, do you know how much they give you? $20.
Oh.
For 1 day.
Yes.
Long hour. And $20. $50. For 1 day. That is to say, they pay you well.
Wow.
That
that is the person really pay you well. Poverty is babbling his head. Last 2 years, no, last year, I traveled last year, October. No, not Corona year.
Yeah, before.
Not Corona year. Year before Corona year. I traveled by October, and this man called with his children to see me. The way the children dress will really tell you that these people are hellfire.
Yeah.
I look at them, they kneel down and say, forgive me. I look at him, I laugh. I said, I never do anything to you. He said, so one man of God said that the way you treated the pastor of where you left, that is why you are suffering. I said, that is what the man said. Yeah. Go to God, don't come to me. I wanted to give them money. God said, if you give them money, you will be any their problem.
Okay.
I have decided to keep him like that for 25 years. And I look at him, I say, how many years now? Says I think that's 4 years that time. 5, 6 years. Because they have 4 children. 6 years. God, you know the kind of woman that as soon as you touch her, she pregnant. That's the kind of wife. That's the kind of wife she has. And in Africa, people that don't have work, people that don't think, they only rest on top of the woman, children jumping on that. And I tell them, they come and I say, I call a pastor, I say, take them to the pastor edge to go and see them, see you guys tomorrow, no problem, give them food and everything. It's in my mind to help, but when I go home to sleep, God said to me, if you try what you want to do, you will inherit what I have given to them. They will be like that for 26 years.
Wow.
He is still in the prison for 6 years. He's going to be completed 20 years in prison. That's what they are. And when I come in the morning, I say to them, it's in my heart to really help people to come out of where you are. But God, I say, first of all, do you believe I'm a man of God? He said, I believe. You know, he knew that I believe and we grow with that test. I say, forget, sit down. No matter what, when they sit down. I said, that's what you believe in. Do you believe I hear from God? He said, yes, do you believe anything I tell you now is what God says? I said, God says you have more 20 years. Your children will be like 25 years, 26 or whatever, before you can find your way out of this dark tunnel. That is your prison sentence. And as a matter of fact, as I'm talking to you, I will not give you transport money. Neither would I tell them to use my car to drop you. The way you come, just go like
this.
And they go. And I don't feel remorse because God says so.
That's right.
Many of us, our character have put us in prison.
That's right.
And you tell me that you are still alive.
Right.
But you're already in jail.
Yeah.
May God help us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Lift up your hand and say, Father.
Father,
remember me.
Remember me.
Say it again.
Father, remember me.
Say the last time.
Father, remember me.
God is about to do something for you. Yeah. You have to retain your miracle by what you say.
Yeah.
Can I hear someone say by what you say?
By what you say.
Say it again, say by what you say.
By what you say.
There is a creative force in your mouth.
Yeah.
Very powerful creative force.
Yeah.
It's in your mouth.
Yeah.
You come to Africa, you see people shouting, amen. People are so easy. People are jumping. And you say, what are they doing? they are creating things.
All right.
I want to change your mentality.
Yeah.
Can I ask someone to change mine first?
Change mine first.
Your victory is sure. Amen. All you need to say, stay awake and devil will stay away.
Yeah.
Stay awake and the devil will stay away. As a matter of fact, from next week, if you are a member of this great commission, if you are not on Zoom, if you come for counseling, you pay me. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
I mean it. If you are not on Zoom,
If you don't join the Zoom, if you come for counseling, you pay me. If you don't want to pay me, you go. I mean what I'm saying. Because we need to continue praying for you and bring you out of here, you are to where you're supposed to be.
Amen.
Be on Zoom. It doesn't take you anything. If you cannot be on 5 o'clock, if you're on 12 o'clock, if you cannot be 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock, or you be in the midnight, 12 o'clock for 15 minutes, simple. Be on any of them. Be on book club. We don't meet for Bible study. We have what we call book club. And it's on Tuesday. That's our Bible study. On Monday. That's our Bible study. And you are not even joining in anything. And you want us to just throw a miracle from there. No problem. I'll be throwing it from there. As soon as COVID is over, I will prophesy. The prophecy I will prophesy will be filling everywhere. And then you know where you are. I'm waiting for COVID to be over. As soon as it's over, I hit the country below the belt. If you are coming here by 2 o'clock, you may not have any place to sit.
No.
I'm telling you. I know who I am. I know what I carry. I know who is me. Oh, my God. Amen. When we're training at the Aquarium, I rent a hall of 25,000 a month in WhatsApp building in Vancouver.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
25,000 a month. And if you come there, you don't get a place to sit.
Back out every night.
Pack up 300
every night.
Capacity. Every night. The place is full.
Yeah.
And you are telling me, you think we are joking? We're not joking. Don't think that anointing has disappeared. It's still there. It's still there. And all we try to do. To make sure you understand what we are doing, so that we can defend the prophecy when it comes to you.
Yeah.
Because then I just say, go and make it, and the person make money. And they say, that man touch you? Are you sure that money is from God, Ethiopia? And dream out of the road. A woman come to see me in church. You are there when they testify. A woman come to see me in church. The first time I look at the song, I say, we're going to pray because I'm not praying for you. I'm praying for this son to see their life, for the father to be alive to see the son. The woman starts crying. What is this? The father is in prison. I said, follow me to the altar. She comes to the altar and sit down and they pray for her. Not even me that pray. You know why I take people to the altar? When you come close to the altar, don't joke. There's something that will help you there that you are not seeing. This is what we take them to the altar. The first time I have the opportunity to go close to the altar of Christ's embassy, I will just pray. Because in Africa, they don't allow you to come close to their altar, you know. For where? Those bodyguards standing in church. Immediately you come, go back. Because they barricade it seriously with humanity. And as soon as the church is over, everybody leave the men or the door, they have different places you can go and have your meeting and eat and whatever. So the man was preaching, and as soon as he finished, he said, pastors from Port Harcourt come. I am not from his church, but I'm a pastor from Port Harcourt.
Yes, the idea instruction.
He said, pastors from Port Harcourt. Actually, in that conference, he's calling pastors of his church from Port Harcourt.
Yeah.
His branches.
Yeah.
I stand up. Let me see the devil that I will say I'm the pastor for. Because that is the opportunity I'm looking for. And I come there, I didn't reach before the pastors from this church. Because they're still like, you know, because they always dress nice. You need to come out and draw your suit. For we are more interested in doing all those movement of I run. The church is big, you know, very big. But because I'm a pastor, I sit closer and all that. Because when you are coming in, you show them, you tell them who you are, they direct you. Sometimes you register online. I run down there. Some people just come to look at this pastor suit because he dressed nice. He speaks good English. He speaks like white.
Yeah.
I don't know whether he never studied abroad, but when he's talking,
yeah,
he would think he's one man from America. even the day he managed to speak Nigerian English, people were like, wow, can this man speak this one? And he told them that he grew in the street too. He knows all his English. I run down there. Some people were crying, grow without tears. The thing that really pained me is that one boy just come there. He take his phone. So he's interested in taking
selfie.
Yeah. So God, you know, the man is there to show that he has come close to me. Nonsense. When I kneel down there, close to the pulpit, I have my white handkerchief. All I do is that because he's staying, even his clothes are all his leg. But it's a little bit far. But the pulpit, I make sure I come close to the pulpit. As he was just praying, I used the handkerchief and cleaned the pulpit. Father, as I'm cleaning this, clean my ministry, clean my life. For this opportunity, I have to come close to this place. I can't jeopardize with him. Holy Spirit, help me. In the name of Jesus, I didn't come the way others come. I come to combat grace. What he carried, I need it. That was it. That was it. No selfie, no picture. Even the picture I got of my is from our website. Amen. That's where I got it. But do you know that that encounter turned things around for me abroad?
Amen.
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 That encounter. Can I tell you this?
No.
This may shock you. After I left with that hanky, as soon as I came to my church and put it in the altar to pray, I said, Father, thank you. And I hear a clear voice from today. They shall be called prophetic embassy.
Wow.
Because his church is called Christ
Embassy.
And we are double ministry, King's Gate Assembly. All my churches, King's Treasure, King this. But God said from today, the church shall be called prophetic embassy. And that stands, and things begin to change. Encounter! With a man with grace can turn your life around.
Oh, yeah.
Encounter with grace can do what?
Turn your life around.
Your victory is sure. All you need is to stay awake, and devil will stay away.
Yeah.
Stay what?
Awake.
And devil will what?
Stay away.
Speak to yourself. Have this encounter with him, and things will change.
Yeah.
I can't forget that I'm going to have the man God. In South Africa. I shared this morning in the morning. The same thing. I enter this church, I see clutches and wheelchairs hanging all over the church. This man removed people from wheelchair. And the wheelchair packed in the church, clutches everywhere. You can't enter the church with wheelchairs, leave wheelchair of people without you saying, I'm not going to go with this. And when you are climbing to go to the church, you see the pictures of any person that come out of wheelchair when they are praying, that thing give me inspiration. When it's praying for you, they take a picture, everything picture, and everywhere is pictures, big pictures, they frame and hang in different areas. This must be good. Then we don't have phones like this, like 2000. All these kind of phones going out. We normally go with ordinary camera. Pastors that travel with me, we are taking pictures. But that is not why I'm there. The grace that removed me from wheelchair. I want it. At that time, that's not 2000. That's not 2000. That's 1989. Yeah, before 1990, because that is really apartheid. Black and white don't sit here.
Yeah.
Why is it here? Black sit here. At that time, I said, I need this grace. Can I hear someone say, I need this grace?
I need this grace.
Say it again.
I need this grace.
Say it last time.
I need this grace.
And the man, so humble, he takes us around to his prayer room. When you enter his prayer room, you see different men of God in his prayer room, enlargement. He put around. Do you know that some of the boys, pastors there, they take us to prayer room, they come out and say, this man is worshiping pictures.
Yes.
The man will come to the picture of prayer book and say, I love this man. You know, he just touches the pictures. Before he come to preach, he said he will go and touch all the pictures of all these great men. Just and so say he's worshiping teachers.
Should
be. I turn my life around.
Amen.
Before him, I see all these things. He now said, I collect this gold. He take it to his brother and say, this is the gold, this gold in the altar. He will take him all the gift, everything they give him. He shared Bible. He mentioned the man of God that gave him a Bible. He said, I don't joke with this Bible. Even my wife, I don't play with it. Can you imagine a white taking blocks? He can be charged for that because it's appetite. You are not supposed to. But he defied those things. And people he defied it for. Come, finish going around with him and say, this man is worshiping pictures.
Yeah.
But after the encounter with that man, my ministry catapulted to this.
Amen.
When he was prophesying to me, when he come to talk to me, he left everybody and come to where we are to talk. I kneel down and hold his shoe. Father, you see this man, what he carry, I need it. And that is the beginning of my ministry. Before you know it, 1995, bam, my first crusade. It was like a bomb.
Wow.
Like a bomb. Don't forget. Don't forget, Dhamma Ministry worldwide.
Worldwide.
My uncle called me and said, you know the person they call worldwide? I said, no, say you. Look at yourself now. Dhamma Ministry worldwide. You are getting it. But that encounter lifted me from the village to the city. Take over the city. And now, online. I don't joke with that. I don't joke with people that have grace. If I discover you have grace, I respect you. And I give you the best opportunity for you to make use of that grace. Because I know what it takes for me to be where I am. It's the grace. I feel like talking. Make use of your mouth. Your mouth is not just for Ruti and Dog. Don't speak what people are speaking.
No.
You know what people are speaking is the corona. They are blaming corona for their poverty.
Yeah.
You know why Cassidy was busy renovating her house during corona? People are building houses during corona. Even this highway going to Aruka Airport there, that place when they lock you down for 1 month, they finish that thing.
Yeah.
People come out of corona. Oh my God! You are inside for corona, you are walking.
Yes,
exactly. Those people that walk on that road, they think that you should be locked up again so that they can get proper contract for that.
Yes.
And they are the ones that say, corona, it is increasing.
Yes.
We need to go back on second lockdown or fourth lockdown because they are benefiting.
Yes.
If they are not benefiting, they will cry the way you are crying. You don't understand human being. Okay, now let's say now, as you are, you don't like corona, you don't like lockdown, right? You don't like lockdown. And the prime minister calls you on phone, and you go to his office, he discusses, I'm going to give you the contract of bringing the vaccine to inject everybody. Will you say no? Say the truth. You got to bring it, right? And when you bring it, how long will you change?
Yes.
She come and say, I take it last week, I'm not dead. You never take it in.
Yes.
I taking last month and I'm not leading. You need to take it. Prime Minister, you lock them again. We need to take this.
And you
now see them going to lobby people in the house. We need to make this mandatory. People must take it. You will shout. You know why? Because you know there is profit. God, there are people that wish that Corona should come back because they benefit.
Yeah.
And there are people that say, God, listen to me, it's not yet over until you win.
Yeah.
Can I hear someone say it's not yet over?
It's not yet over
until I win.
Until I win.
Your miracle is the product of your mouth.
America
is the
product of
my mind. I will use it powerfully.
I will use it powerfully.
It's not too late.
It's not too late.
To win.
To win.
Say it again. Say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
To win.
To win.
Say it last time.
It's not too late to win.
Say it and believe it.
It's not too late to win.
Say it last time.
It's not too late to win.
Do you believe it's too late?
No.
It's not too late. It's never too late. It can never be too late. You will. When you see men with grace, respect them.
Yeah.
When you see men with grace, do what?
Respect them.
There are people that what they're doing for you now, you think is nothing.
Yeah.
So only tomorrow you know that what they're doing for you is
real.
It's just like Prophet Itode Iloye page. I did not put my Christy CFJ on that page. When they have an attack from the Nigerian government, when they shut down everything, all the information I have, I could have come. Because it's only through the number one that you can come back to the page. They shut down the number one that we can't retrieve it back again. So that is how the page is there. And some of the video we have is the one Christy record on her phone. Some people may think that she just recorded. Sometimes she records, sometimes she needs her money to finance some things.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
There are things people do for you
that
you may not know.
Yeah.
You may not value it.
But.
Amen.
Amen.
All the people that say, cast me stop driving you, we'll be driving you. Where are they?
Yes.
Where are they? I'm driving you. You don't want a woman to drive you. We'll be driving.
One.
They're gone. Some of them say, "No, I'm not going. Buy the car in my name." And he did my stupidly without knowing that they have already stole my 1.6 million before. When I didn't know Trinidad people, and I fall again by using money to buy car in their name. And now when they go, all they will do, they will not even come to me, they go to police and say, I'm having their car, and the police will come and take my car and leave them.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Because I buy it again. Nicodemus. Listen to me. Don't listen to what people say.
No.
Anything that cannot make you happy, don't do it.
No.
Anything that makes you happy, do what?
Do it.
Life is not a fanfare.
No,
life is a warfare. If you don't fight, life fights you. Can I hear someone say, I hear you. That is why we want to fight some certain things on 28th of this month.
Yeah.
From 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock. Make sure you find yourself in good altar of slaughter. Mountain of fire. So people here, you don't even need to get a car. Okay, Johnny is here. Johnny can discuss with you. You can hire a Max. Hire Johnny's Max. Okay, Johnny will take you people there and bring you people here. You go to your house. It's very important. Don't miss it. If you miss it, it's as if you miss help.
Amen.
There are some people that don't understand anything. See Uncle Johnny here. Uncle Johnny give the church Maxi. A whole Maxi. Say, come and take They say the tire is long. They say the tire. The tire of the vehicle is not good. Man of God, tell him to change it. Somebody give you car. Come and take it. Maxi.
Yes, yes.
Even the church Maxi. They say the tire. Somebody come to church, bring the documents. Say, this is for church. To help the church to go and bring people from everywhere. You know, it's not that I know why it worked. They were quarreling. Which name would they put it? Because they did not they refused to go and rectify the registration of the church to put themselves as directors. So they were running around, okay, if they, which person's name are we going to? They start quarreling within themselves. People don't come to church for God, they come to church for profit.
That's right.
All the pastors here don't think we are paying anybody, we are not paying nobody. Is the church paying your rent? Is the church paying your rent? Bishop, is the church paying your rent? Bishop is coming from Palaseco. If the church is in Palaseco, many of you know. Church, all of you. It's just a few people that know that we're going to.
Truth.
I'm not doing someone here. You're giving me a robbing thing. The church don't pay my house. Please. Have the church ever given me check for house?
No.
The church don't pay my house. Amen. I'm still here.
Amen.
The church don't pay for the car music.
No.
I'm still here. The food I eat in the house, the church don't pay for it. It's costly that normally supply food. I don't know how she supplies food.
Thank you, Lord.
And I say, God, thank you.
Amen.
It's Christy that normally give me money for food. God, thank you.
Amen.
I'm going to get somebody here.
Yeah.
That's what you should.
Amen.
Now, if I begin, are you sure those ladies, are you sure they're not his friend? Because you have malaria.
Yeah.
Malaria problem. Amen. Pray, God.
Yeah.
When God gives you people, do what?
Amen.
Lift up your hands and Father, I value you.
Father, I value you.
It's not too late for me to succeed.
It's not too late for me to succeed.
You know it's not too late for you to succeed. All I normally tell people, everything you put in place, take it very serious.
Amen.
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 Take it very serious. Find your way to your covenant tree.
That's right.
See, it's every day. The place is crystal. It's really doing wonderful.
Amen.
She's here every day.
Amen.
You don't even buy her gas.
No.
Amen.
Amen.
She's here every day. Why not make out her? See her. Discuss. Enter into the covenant tree. Talk to your God.
Amen.
Not when we are here today and you know that we finish. You say, I want to enter the covenant tree by 6 o'clock and by 7 o'clock. This is not our beauty. Is a
wrong.
But you don't come in the daytime. Take your time off.
Yes.
Sit there. Deal with your issue.
Yes.
And you will see heaven bless you.
Yes.
Can I hear someone say, So on 28, don't miss it. All you need to do, buy a lock. We are not selling the lock. Buy a lock. The only thing we sell to you is a pot. That I will tell you what to do. We take a pot there and you drop it on the altar and go home. Very important. Get the lock. Get any lock you want. I'll tell you what to do with it. It's very important. And on the 14th of next month, Lover's Day, it's called Prophetic Lover's Night. Where is my mama? She gone? Okay. Because she must come for that Lover's Night. Yeah. It's a Prophetic Lover's Night. I don't know if we have branches. And we are accommodating only 80 people. Only 80. It's zero because of COVID. So restriction, only 80 people were completed, not 100. I discussed with my different for 100, but I said 80. Because I come to church today, I look around and discover like 100
people.
Wow. So 80, I space out for 80. And it's going to be wonderful, and it's going to be more. Yeah. I tell you, don't miss it. I tell you. Don't miss it. And we give everybody the opportunity to know each other.
Yes.
Know what each other is doing.
Yes.
We give you mic. You tell us what you do. Okay. Do you know that I may be what I'm looking for? You may be the one that is in the office.
Yes. Yes.
If I don't know you,
yes.
I come to church, I walk straight, and I don't know you are the person. You know, there are some people that is working in HDC house.
Yeah. Yeah.
That may be the person that will just carry your fire. Put it on top. So you need to be there. And when you are coming, dress well. Dress okay. Dress seriously. Do your, if you like to fix that 18 inches, 100 inches, fix it. Even if the hair is touching the ground, no problem, we can get people to hold it for that. Amen. If you don't know where to buy high heel shoe, please check out Crystal. Crystal will help you. If you don't know where to buy good bag, check out Cascars. This one will help you to really put yourself together. If you don't know where to do your nails, check out Mommy Judy's daughter.
Yeah.
She did come today. Do your nails. Fix yourself seriously. Now I'm here. I see her on Facebook.
Oh, yeah.
Really good. But if you have a small head, don't go there and say, do me this one. Just allow her to give you the head that will help your life. Amen. So we need to really be there on that day, and it's only in Shogona. And it's on Sunday evening. So the church here will finish before 4:30 on that day so that they can find themselves there. We start by 6 o'clock and we'll end by 8 o'clock. In case if you're going to be there, make sure you register $200. Very important. People will win prizes, the best nail, the best dresser, the best couple, the best next.
Yay!
So everybody will pick them. Not the best. Amen. So everybody will really be there. If you don't have a lover, take yourself out.
Amen.
On that day, love yourself.
Amen.
Amen. Register and come by yourself. And come and sit down. And enjoy. We are going to cast the dying man of your boyfriend of saxophone. Please book him in time for us. Castly and Castly can't play with a man. Party say that man must come. You know, Castly is really marketing the man. And the man is good in saxophone. So the man can bring saxophone for us so we can dance to the glory of God. It's very important. Please, everybody, come that day and come and make yourself happy.
Yeah.
Take yourself out because we're going to drink, we're going to dance, we're going to know each other. Print your complimentary card in Aruba. Print your complimentary card, come on time. Amen. If any of our elderly women is coming, I want to take the responsibility of waking them up. To make sure you can see Mama Sarah, just call me Mama Sarah with you. Amen. It's going to be wonderful. Can I ask because it's not too late?
It's not too late.
It's not too late. So everybody should make sure that they join that day and see what God is about to do.
Amen.
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 If you have not delivered the baby, come with your pregnancy. We may even have the best pregnant woman dressing. Amen. If the baby did not come before then, just be there. Amen. It's not too late. Can I say it's not too late?
It's not too late.
Say because it's not too late.
It's not too late.
Say the last time.
It's not too late.
what you don't appreciate today, you will not get it tomorrow. Appreciate yourself.
Amen.
Take yourself out. Forget about people that have money. I believe it's only a man that can get it. Don't allow it. Take yourself out.
Amen.
If nobody loves you,
love
and I want you to think big, think mighty, think. Yeah, man.
Yeah,
man. We're having a prophet. Cause now.
Yeah.
14th. Prophetic lovers night. Lift your hand and say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
Say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
As I close this mic, I want you to know it's not too late for Jesus.
Amen.
People are giving testimonies.
Yes.
Like the woman I talk about right now, that I was talking to him about this song.
Yeah.
And I say, I take him to the altar after prayers. Today she come and say, the fact I've been released after 2 years.
Amen.
They talk, you know, they're not meeting physically. On Zoom from prison.
Yeah.
They just look at him. Don't forget, this prayer was prayed on Wednesday.
Yeah.
On Friday was his court case.
Yeah.
They just look at him on Zoom and say, what's your name? Mention? How many years have you been there? 2 years and 6 months. Go on. Next. That is how you come out.
Yes.
So you're coming from there to God. Stop being there. Go.
Come on.
Don't you think that your own can be there?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Just so.
The woman come to church today, her teeth is everywhere.
Oh.
Her teeth is everywhere. Some of you, your boyfriend will be locked up. Instead of you to pray for him to come out, you pick up and down.
Yeah.
Your girlfriend lock up instead of you to be praying for she to come out to pick up and love. Now, time and God will stand for.
Yeah.
Can I hear someone say it's not too late?
It's not too late.
Pick up an offering of $50, $100, and say, Father, it's not too late.
Not too late.
As commander touch my head, it's not too late. What have been delayed for a long time?
It's not too late. It's
not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. Drop it on the altar. I want to lay hand on you. It's not too late. Grandson, it's not too late. It's not too late. Mercy ahead. It's not too late. With my $50, $100, it's not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. My best. It's not too late. It's not too late. I have $20. I have $1. I have PNA. It's not too late. 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 Where is your song? Okay. It's not too late. Can I ask because
it's not too late?
It's not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. Even if you want to marry tomorrow, even if you're 100 days, you want to marry tomorrow, it's not too late. It's not too late. It's not too late. Can I hear someone say it's not too late?
It's not too late.
Say it again, say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
Say it again, say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
Baby, say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
Lift up your hand and say, Father.
Father.
Father,
it's not too late for me to succeed.
It's not too late for me to succeed.
Stand up, clap your hand, and make it a prayer. One, two, three, you know.